Okay, so the first thing you see is this dialog. It's going to ask you to only search some documents for pictures, or you can search all my whole computer for pictures. You can search the whole of your computer for pictures. This is the default setting. You can say continue, and it's going to search for this type of pictures, pictures with this format. All these formats are going to be imported, so you can just click on finish, and it's going to search all your computer for photos immediately. Can set up backup, and you can say not now. So it's searching for images from your computer over here. So once it's finished searching the images, it's going to categorize them according to folders. You can see Adobe Premiere Pro and all these images that you have in your computer that you saved somewhere. It's going to categorize them accordingly, and you can see the different folders. Okay, albums, people who are connected to this, and projects. You know, we've created a movie or something. So you have the option to look into this, and you can import any photos from a camera or from a scanner or from other medias directly into the Picasa editor. So down here you have the option to look at your picture inwards here. So you can look at your pictures across. In here you have the option to this is the movies button, movie site. So you have the option to bring in images in here. You can say move this image, you can move this image as well. So let's say we have these two and we want to make a simple movie with it. You are free to bring in other pictures as well if you have them, so you can bring in accordingly. Let's say we bring in this picture as the last picture, we move it here, and then you can just come over and create a movie presentation. You can click on this and you can create a movie presentation. So you are free to bring in different kind of things. From the left here you can see the library where we just left, and then this is the movie maker. So down here you have the movies. You can import any kind of media, maybe it's an audio track, you can bring it in. You can change the transition accordingly. Right now it's set to dissolve. You can put in other transitions. You can see push, you can see circle, and you can see dissolve through white. You can select anyone, and then you can play around with the duration. Each slide should stay maybe 1.5 seconds and overlap should be maybe, let's say, 20%. And you can see the dimension. You can play around with the dimension over here. You can increase or decrease accordingly. You can show caption, you can do full frame photo crop over here, and you can create the movie directly, or you can upload to YouTube. Now over here you can edit the slides, you can put in text, you can bring in templates from a template. Okay, so over here you can see we have our text welcome. Okay, you are free to select it and increase the size. We can increase the size, and we can go to the next one. And you are free to add text from here also, add new text slide. So you can add a new text slide and you can put in anything. So let's say remember to subscribe. So once you're done writing, you can play around with text, you can bold, you can italize, you can change the coloration as well, all right, to something like this, and you can change the caption as well. Down here you have the clips, you can work on the clips. This is the clip 1, clip 2, clip 3. You want to bring in get more slides, you can get from here. You can add the selected clip from here, so any clip you see, you can get more clips. Assuming you want to bring in this one, it's part of the movie, so once you click on it you can add it to your timeline, and you can see it over here. Once you're done adding all the pictures and you are done playing around with the properties as well as the movie styles, the transition and the dimensions and all, you can come over straight and create a movie over here, or you can close. So you create a movie and it's going to create the movie directly for you. All right, so you can see a preview, welcome, and you can see the pictures. Okay, you can see remember to subscribe, and down here you have this picture and the last one, second to the last, then the last one. You can see the transition as it is. And you can upload this to YouTube directly. So once you make your videos, you can put in audio tracks and you can take a snapshot at any given point, and then you can export the clip into your computer or to any kind of device that you drive that you have attached to your computer. You can easily do that. Let's say we go back to the library. In cases when you want to do any kind of editing to your pictures, you can just double click on it and it's going to bring you to this Picasa editor. So over here you have the option to crop. For example, I can crop the image. You can select from manual selection, or you can use these dimensions to crop, or I prefer to use the manual one. So you can just select a particular place where you want to crop, so you can crop accordingly. You can increase or decrease, and once you specify the place you want to crop, you can easily preview it, right? And then once you can reset to the normal one, or you can apply. So let's say we select this and you want to check to take this, and you can just apply. So it takes only this. Alright, so you can do some sort of editing over here. There are a lot of editing tools. You can bring in text to it. You can put in some text. Alright, and you can move it to any location. And you can play around with the coloration as well. Right now it's set to white. You can make it any color by clicking here. You can edit the color. You can make it gradient or don't show solid color. You can increase the, you can play around with the opacity down here, and you can arrange the, play around with the alignment and style over here. You can bold, you can italize, and all, you can do all that. You can increase the size or decrease the size accordingly. You can change the font size. Once you're done, you click on apply. You can do some retouch over here. You can play around with the brushing. Okay, you can just play around with the brush size. So once you get the brush size, you can come over here and you can do some retouch. And once you're done, you can do auto coloration. It is going to optimize the coloration directly. You can straighten the color. You can take care of red eyes in cases when you have red eyes, and you can put in I'm feeling lucky sign. So you can do so series of editing. You can increase or decrease the fill light. You can increase or decrease the fill light accordingly, and you can see the effect. Brightness, you can come over and you can do a lot of editing over here. You can change the brightness accordingly, and you can change the highlights and make it looks much more professional, and you can edit accordingly as well. Then over here you have the other different default options to select from. You can select this one, you can select this, anyone you choose, anyone you feel is okay for you, you can select. Or you can use this B&W, black and white. So down here you have other options to select from, anyone that you feel is better for you. You have other options also. You can apply the changes or discard the changes directly. So these are a series of other options that you can check and see and edit maybe and add to your view. So you can get back to the library. You can, once you're satisfied with it, you can save this or you can play it to see the preview. So this is just a preview. You can undo, you can redo, you can play, you can start this and then get back to it later. And then there are a series of slides that you have arranged already, and then you can put in slides, change the view from single image to side by side. You can view two different images, and then you can view the same image side by side. Down here you have the range of things to check. You can email this, you can print this, you can export it to any kind of file or any location within your computer, and you can undo, redo, start this and all that. You can share directly, or you can increase or decrease the sizing. You can put in locations, or you can collaborate with others down here. And over here you have a series of options, so it's up to you to just check and try to see what you can do. You can save as, you can save a copy, you can export the picture directly from here, or you can create new album or different kind of albums, import images or other documents from other drives and just put them in this file, and then you can manipulate them. You can edit, you can copy paste text as well as the view. You can change the view, the library view, just shown how you can people and then maybe show in side by side, or you can play around with different display mode over here. And then over here you have the picture view. You can do different kind of views. You can create, set this as a desktop, you can set it as a desktop screensaver, or you picture collage, or make a poster, or add a screensaver, use this as a screensaver, or you can add or bring in different kind of things to add. Okay, these are different kind of tools. You can just experiment them to see how and what works for you and what doesn't work for you. So this is a very, very fantastic software that you can use easily to view your pictures and to edit them to your liking. This is just a brief about Picasa. It's very easy to use and open source software that you can easily download and use for yourself. So ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and always hit the like and subscribe button to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.